will be coached by Herman Krupp, and the blue team will be coached by Ben McCaffrey.
This is QCC alum David Russell. The Queensborough alumni game about to begin. The blue team will face the red team, and then they'll team up and take on the current Queensborough Tigers. The red team is being coached by Herman Krupp, currently an assistant on the women's team. Should see a lot of good Queensborough players from years past today. Sabrina Moore will be playing, Nikki Tiberi, Shantana Kanoy, Alicia Barrow, Dominique Williams, Candice Etienne. The blue team has Elise Langley, Latasha Harris, Anne-Marie Johnson. A lot of recent players, and joining me today for the alumni game is Joe Massey.
Good to be back with you again, David, and it's another old-timers day here at Queensborough.
Not so old, a lot of these players from
not
the
so
past
old,
few
right?
years.
Recently retired, some of them. Some of them went on and played in another level, too.
Yeah, the red team has Sabrina Moore, Nikki Tiberi, Shantana Kanoy, Alicia Barrow, Candice Etienne, and Dominique Williams. Roster we've gotten. And the blue team, Ariel Merville, Elise Langley, Latasha Harris, Anne-Marie Johnson, Ludesi Gonzalez, Naisia Irby, and Sabrina Rodriguez.
Nikki Tiberi, remember, that was like the start of the Queensborough domination when Nikki was there.
She was the Rookie of the Year in CUNY in 2006. And then 2008, she was Player of the Year in CUNY, which was the first time Queensborough won the CUNY Championship.
Dominique Wilkins, I used to call her, by mistake sometimes when I was doing the game, because she's Dominique Williams.
Sometimes you were joking, sometimes not.
No, sometimes I actually made that mistake. But before the game, I saw Alicia Barrow warming up, and I remembered her distinctly because of the strong move she used to make. And we were joking around. The ball bounced to the corner, and I passed the ball back to her behind my back. She said, "I thought you were going to take a shot." I says, "No, I'm strictly a passer now."
You and spared us all?
I asked her, I says, "What's your name again?" And she told me, "Barrow." And I said, "I remember the way you used to play." She was a take-no-prisoners type player.
Barrow in the red jersey going to jump against Ludesi Gonzalez in the blue.
Got a good sample of some of those good Queensborough players on hand here.
And here's one with the ball now, Sabrina Rodriguez, who's the Region 15 Player of the Year.
Yeah, most recent vintage. And she's out, right? And
yeah,
is she playing anywhere right now?
Not sure. Not sure if she played her two at Queensborough. That shot was blocked.
I was wondering if I was going to see the big girl who went over to Queens College from here, the center. Can't think of her name right now. I'll come up with it at some point.
Shot is no good. And rebounded by Ludesi Gonzalez. Here's Latasha Harris, number 10, with the ball who gave it to Rodriguez.
I want to see how fast Moore is number 2 now. She gets the ball.
Here's Kanoy.
She had a couple of good years here. Oh, wow. Nice strip.
Rodriguez with the steal and the layup. It's 2-0 Blue Team. We saw that a lot when she played here.
She can still do it, huh?
She was the Region 15 Player of the Year in 2012.
She was very good at playing those passing lanes, Dave.
Yeah.
That's a very good strength of hers.
Three-pointer is no good, and Rodriguez got the hand in to knock away a potential offensive rebound. Playing Rodriguez didn't win CUNY Player of the Year, but she won Region Player of the Year. As Harris misses a three. Natasha Harris put up a lot of three-pointers when she played here.
Yeah.
She was here the Bob DiNardo year. Her and Jacqueline Torres, they combined to take a lot of three-pointers that season. Rodriguez couldn't put it in. It's good to see Kanoy against Rodriguez, and here's Kanoy all the way.
Yeah, those last two great players here.
Kanoy won CUNY Player of the Year in 2013. And then she led the Lady Tigers to the CUNY Championship last year.
Yeah, she came through in the tournament, right? Came through in the tournament.
Yeah, that was a good redemption story for her.
You and I were sitting up here in, February last year, maybe the beginning of March, hoping they could beat that team that came in here, Sullivan, I believe.
Yeah, they lost to Sullivan in the region playoffs.
She was playing in that game, right?
Yeah, Kanoy was in that. It's funny, the 2013 CUNY playoff game, Kanoy had 14 turnovers against Hostos. That shot is no good. And then last year, like I said, good redemption story is Morris shoots an air ball.
I think Kanoy had a decent game against Sullivan, but they were a little outflanked in that game.
Yeah. Sometimes you see alumni games where players go at half speed. Moore isn't going to do that. She got Rayon Gonzalez. Rodriguez puts up a three, and it's good.
She has the only points of the day so far, five of them. That was a three.
3 minutes and 15 seconds in, it's 5-0, Sabrina Rodriguez.
Our buddy is coaching one team over there.
Yeah, Herman Crump. Losing 5-0 right now, and we won't let him live it down if he can't come back.
Who's coaching the other ball club?
Ben, that's Coach Rodriguez, is fouled.
Ben McCamery.
A lot of the players have been on CUNY championship winning teams. QCC has won 5 of the last 7 CUNY titles.
Is Ben also a member of that staff now over there on the women's side?
I'm not sure.
Yeah. She's got all 6 points.
Yeah.
So far, the Sabrina Rodriguez show.
Our scoring column is pretty easy to look at. 7-0 Sabrina Rodriguez.
I used to see her dad all over the place, too. I saw him down at Baruch. Big basketball fan. Wouldn't be surprised if he were here today.
Nice behind-the-back pass. Then we'll dribble it out.
Of course, it's always nice to be fancy in these games when you have an opportunity, too.
Simone Leathers fired that pass. Unfortunately, fired it onto the bench of the blue team, so that's a turnover.
Too much mustard on the leather. You say too much mustard on that hot dog.
Queensboro won 4 CUNY titles in a row, 08 through 11, and then won a 5th title in 2014. That shot is good. It's Ludesi Gonzalez.
Somebody else gets on the scoring column here.
How about that? 9-0 blue team. There's a turnover.
Kind of telegraphed that pass a little bit, and Gonzalez stepped in there and was waiting for it.
And here's Gonzalez again. From the same spot, couldn't score that time, and there's a tie-up underneath. It's amazing how many times Queensboro lost in the CUNY Championship game before they finally got over the hump. When BMCC, remember, they had their stretch of 7 or 8 titles in a row. 4 times they beat Queensboro in the CUNY title game. And then Hostos won 4 titles in a row, and 3 of those championship game wins came against Queensboro.
Yeah, well, Hostess had a dynamic program at that time. They really did. And then Queensborough took over. And they had a dynamic program with Joseph Medina.
Here's Gonzalez again. That shot is no good.
I believe is somewhere on the West Coast now, somewhere.
I believe he may be in Florida. That was the last
Florida.
I heard.
Florida, right?
It's close enough to the West Coast, right? Remember, there was Yuriko Jung before Medina?
Yeah, she did a fabulous job. They had a big write-up on her in the Daily News the year that she made the final.
She was CUNY Coach of the Year once.
Yep.
And there's a... Weathers may have gotten away with traveling and then threw it out of bounds. I think they may say it was last touched by somebody on the blue team, though.
And then the gal from the NYCAC coached them a few years, and she did a very good job with them.
Kanoi ends the shutout. It's 9-3. Rodriguez now with the ball. There was one year Queensborough won one game, which was here against Kingsborough. And Kingsborough also had one win that year. That came against Queensborough.
Yeah, there was some very lean years.
It's a nice way of putting it. They weren't lean for BMCC or Hostos, though.
But they had pretty good players all the time.
I would say the conference is a lot deeper now than it was when Jung was coaching.
Yeah, the whole conference, because BMCC was just so good, the women. They were just beating everybody handily. I mean, nobody can even play with them. For years, they just kept winning title after title. Of course, they were playing on their home court. But I don't even think that mattered. Thing is, they had 6'2", 6'1", 6-foot players, terrific guards, and nobody could beat them. Even when they played a bad game, they couldn't beat. They couldn't come close.
They have the CUNY title game record. They won one of those games by 52 points. And Queensborough came close. Last year, they won the CUNY title game by 50. They were actually up by 55, and then Bronx scored a few points at the end to make it a 50-point game.
There you go.
Yeah. Sabrina Rodriguez.
Adding on to her hefty total.
10 points.
A nice early afternoon's work so far.
So it's 12-3 blue team, and Rodriguez has 10 of those.
Well, that's the only place they used to play the championship game, down at Borough of Manhattan College. Every year they used to play it. And then they built that nice place at Kingsborough, and they started moving it out there. At Queensborough, by the way, did have it one or two times during that span also. They used to play it basically at Borough Manhattan, and Queensborough had a couple of them. I think the ladies lost here on their home court one year in the final.
I think they also had it at Hostos a few times.
Then they had it at Hostos when they came in, because they didn't come in until about 2003 or so. But it was basically a BMCC affair, with Queensborough having a couple of them.
New players on the court. Here's a familiar one. Kanoi, another three, but that one is no good. And Williams with the rebound. Kanoi again going to the basket and puts it in off glass. Kanoi with all 5 points for the red team.
This year's Queensborough squad, by the way, is a young one. Herman Crump telling us earlier that it's a younger squad than they've had, but he expects them to round into form. We'll see them later on here today.
Irby picked up the air ball. Rodriguez fakes a three, goes inside, and puts it in off glass. A dozen points for Rodriguez. It's 14-5.
She was ready for this game, huh?
I think so. Early favorite for player of the game.
Oh, a nice in-close shot given to Kanoi, and she couldn't hit it. So far,
fortunately for Queensborough, she hit most of those when she played here.
The matchup has gone to Rodriguez so far, though.
Gonzalez misses that one.
David, it's a team game, and we'll see if the red squad can put it together and narrow this lead here.
Leather steps into a three, and that's good. 14-8.
Nice shot. good shot, too. Wasn't a shot you shouldn't have taken with your team down by nine. And it gets them right back in the game.
Rodriguez thought about the three. Gonzalez outside. Harris steps into one. That's no good. Rodriguez with the rebound. Couldn't put it in, though. Good defense by Irby. Williams. Well, she spun with the ball. Candace Etienne, and she spun right into three players on the blue team, and Rodriguez
all the way.
Yeah.
And she got fouled. By the way, Canoy, one fella, not going to disclose who they are, but he was he had his oars in the water in terms of people around. He said Canoy was going to get some opportunities, but it's a question of whether people wanted to see how serious she was to go on to the next level. I don't really know. I haven't been following what happened to her since she left here, but she was perhaps going to get some pretty good offers from some teams.
Here are a few more recent players on the court now. Jacqueline Torres, Elise Langley.
Yeah, a little Langley. She would do a real good job when she got in the game.
Rodriguez splits the free throws. It's 15-8, blue team. Williams, they say, fouled by Irby.
Good job by Dominique there, getting all the way down on the right side.
Williams won the Burt Beagle Sportsmanship Award during her time here. She's a good player on some Medina teams.
Well, they named that one the right way.
Williams misses the first.
Excuse me.
Williams misses both. Moore couldn't save it in, and then she's pointing at Rodriguez. Now, this looks like the 2012 team with Langley, Rodriguez, and Torres. We'll see if Torres puts up a three, how long that'll take, if we're being true to the 2012 team. And there's an up and down violation.
You don't like to commit mistakes even in this game, and they're laughing a little bit about it, but could have narrowed, or it could have widened the lead there, and they don't get an opportunity.
There's a three-pointer, which is airballed. Torres picks it up. Good defense by Williams, who last touched it.
Sabrina has the hot hand. Let's see if she can keep it here.
In the corner, Irby for three. It's an air ball. Moore.
There's one of her moves that she would make in the past, but she fell away at the last moment.
Rodriguez was fouled, and she'll go to the line for two.
Yeah, she's got 12 of the 15 points. 12 of the 15 registered by the blue squad. Pretty good day's work so far, but you can't ring in that free throw there.
It's been a pretty quick game, 9:56 to go in the first half. Remember, Herman coached the alumni game last year and called five timeouts. Misses both. There's an offensive rebound. Going inside, and it
blocked
was blocked
from
behind. Yeah.
By Moore.
I think Williams, Dominique Williams,
yeah,
had
Dominique
the block.
Williams. Yep.
There's a three-pointer, and that's no good. Fifteen-8, blue team, halfway through the first.
Three-pointer would have put it right back in the ballpark there.
There have been 23 points in this game so far, and two players have combined for 18 of them, as that shot is no good. Rodriguez hoists up a three, and that's no good.
Guess they're settling for the outside shot right now.
And Moore is happy to get the foul called.
Moore's been around here several years since she finished her playing days here, and she was one of the more dynamic players in this program, and she was with Joe Mead for a couple of years, just on the brink of when they started to become the powerhouse.
She was on the 07 team that made the CUNY title game and lost 60-12.
And they were becoming a good team at that time, even though they lost by that score. They were sort of putting it together. You know, you could see it. And they brought in some new players the next year, and they really put the pedal to the metal, as they say. Good
There's
rebound.
A basket. Alicia Barrow makes it 15-10. So after all of that, the red team is only down by five.
Real team player, Barrow.
And there's now a three by Torres, which is airballed.
Yep.
No, it was only a matter of time until she would take that.
Too, yeah. As I talk over David. Oh,
nice pass.
Nice pass.
Moore puts it in. Nikki Tiberi fired it into Moore. 15-12.
Nikki, nice pass there. All right, Rodriguez hasn't scored in a little bit.
And Torres.
Gives it up to Torres. Torres, a good outside shooter.
See if she takes this one.
Here.
Oh. Giving it to Langley, who takes a long shot, and it's no good. Another offensive rebound. Rodriguez lost it. Red team has the ball.
See if they can really get into that lead now.
Oh, that would have tied the game. Moore can't believe it rimmed out. Under 8 minutes to play in the first.
Moore playing defense now and cuts off the drive, but a good follow. That was very nice by Rodriguez.
15 points for Rodriguez. 17-12 blue team.
Yeah, it's red against Rodriguez.
So there's a three-pointer, which is no good. Just grazed the rim.
Who hit it? Number 11 hit it for the red.
It was Molina who took the three. As some subs come in. Langley to the bench. Ludesi Gonzalez back in.
But during that span when they were winning, there was a typical type of Queensborough player that kept showing up year after year with Joe Mead. And he had come from the... I think it was a women's professional league, didn't he? WNBA, something like that.
They had Kiara Bryant here.
Well, I did a professional league with the men, and this league had the same name, I think. Almost like the USBL.
Yeah, Medina's coached men and women. That shot is no good. Moore takes it away from Torres.
Whoa.
Gets it to Molina.
Got to take care of those knees, Sabrina. And she got an open shot there, Tiberi, and she couldn't sink it, so it's still a five-point game.
A few years ago, Tiberi had 20-something points in an alumni game, maybe even been 30.
A few years ago, she would have a lot of points in a regular game. She could do it all. Underground, overground, she was that type of player. Good passer.
She was the best player on the first championship team in Queensborough history as that three is off.
And Katrina Robinson is not here today. It was a terrific player.
Zakonja Bethea.
Bethea.
Giselle Prentice in more recent years. Under 6 minutes to play in the first. Blue team leading 17-12. There's a corner three, which is an air ball.
Let me see your record book there. I'll come up with the girl that was playing center here. A very good player. When they weren't like a top team. There's a basket.
Irby gets in the scoring column. It's 19-12. Molina. Back outside. Barrow was asking for it.
You know what it is, David? It's hard to get any info on the women's community college because I told you BMCC just dominated that thing year after year. So they were all the top players back from that era that I'm talking about.
Timeout was called. So a chance for some subs to come in. Blue team leading 19-12.
Up until 2:04, they had their last player of the year, LaToya Steele, at Manhattan. And then Hostos had a big run on the player of the year with Shanna Hamilton, LaTanya Grady, Christina Carter. And then Queensboro, Nikki Tiberi wrested away the MVP from those girls.
And then it went back to Hostos with Tiffany Robinson.
And it went right back to Hostos with Robinson. Then it came to Manhattan with Molina, who was a terrific player. And then it was Kiana Bryant, who we didn't mention here today, another Queensboro player who won it.
And then it went back to Hostos in 12 with Sherbin.
Lots of good women's play. Lots of good. The girls we mentioned, though, were very good. Here's the community college tournament going back to 98. Once again, you're not going to get any help with that because Rodney Carr won Coach of the Year every year. And then a Manhattan player won the most valuable player. So I can't come up with that information right now.
And for good measure, Rodney won a few more titles at Hostos.
Yeah, he won two at Hostos after the lady that was coaching them, Renee Bostic, moved on. And by the way, Renee Bostic broke his skein at Manhattan. And she was an assistant with Rodney, and then she wound up beating Rodney.
Blue team up by 7, 4.5 minutes to play in the first.
4:27, first half, yes.
Torres steps into a three, and that one is no good. Missing never stops her from taking his.
Langley trying to get in the way, and she did to draw that offensive foul. By the way, David, years go by, and you just forget about everything, but I just picked up a tape yesterday of a cassette I had. Someone was doing a sports report. You know who the coach of Boston College football was?
No.
Tom Coughlin,
yeah. In the early 90s?
Yeah. And he was talking just like he does today, playing Notre Dame that week.
Well, you always got to be up for the Irish, you know, because they really control the ball. And
so, you know, just things just blend in with each other is what I'm trying to get at here.
Kanoi takes a three. And misses. There's another miss, but that will lead to two free throws.
So I snapped into back to today again because I said, well, Tom Coughlin here, he's a young man almost. It's probably about in his 40s. And now they're talking about him being too old to coach, 68. Or perhaps too old to coach. We'll see.
First free throw is no good.
Where did all those years go? 19-12 is the score, by the way, and they're not able to get any closer here.
It's taken away.
See if they can do it this time with the ball.
Off-balance shot is no good.
Not good-looking shots, by the way.
Especially when they don't go in.
And not have a chance to go in.
Gonzalez got away with the travel and then threw up a shot that fell well short of the basket.
There you go.
And that'll be a tie-up between Leathers and Harris.
little buck step there, and she tried to drop the ball off, and everybody getting twisted and foul called. Still anybody's ball game, though.
Here's Elise Langley. Unfortunately, played the 2 years that Queensboro hasn't won a title. They won 5 in the last 7. She played in 12 and 13.
They were right in the mix, though.
They were.
But no, they couldn't get over top.
2012, they were regular season champions. As that shot is good, it's a long two. It's 21-12.
I guess they won't let them come back in this game. Now they're going to play a little zone here. Try to mix things up.
Nice spin move, but not that nice because she's called for traveling.
Yeah, Leather's getting caught up in the spin and dragging her pivot foot.
The spin was so nice, she forgot to put the ball on the floor.
Well, that you always have to do, unless you are a major move already. Certain players, they've made a career out of almost a travel move. You know, they made a traveling move and never got called for it.
Well, Rodriguez just got called for
she
that
got
one.
Called for travel. But certain players have been able to get away with it and then, you know, make it like a patented move.
That's what happens when you're a star.
Yeah.
The refs will look the other way.
And somehow they're able to do it in a way that you just don't call it a walk, and they get it, you know, they're so smooth with it.
Under 2 minutes to play in the half, Moore
Whoop.
Is fouled.
That could have been a traveling right there, but she did get hit hard, and she'll go to the free throw line. Well, Moore, she had a lot of explosiveness in her days here. I mean, she could get up and down the court, and she could, she didn't get tired. You know, you couldn't stop her. That's what was outstanding about it. She just never stopped.
Moore makes the first.
I remember I would talk to Rodney Carr down at BMCC about some of his players on an everyday basis, because we would cover them a lot in those days. And he would call one girl his Energizer Bunny. Just kept moving. He just couldn't stop her. I think it was Robinson. Crystal Robinson. There have been a few good Robinsons in this conference, by the way.
Turnaround jumper is no good. Taken down. 95 seconds to play in the half.
They need something good here. There you go. Good pass. Easy shot, but she couldn't make it.
Had a clean look.
Yep. She tried to bank it, which is the proper thing to do also. Here's Langley.
Irby left alone for three, and it's good. Irby makes it 24-13. She has 5 points now.
Could hear that PA guy going, Irby. 23-13, a 10-point lead. The Red not able to shake off their early woes here.
Rodriguez Steel. Takes it away.
Actually, a give up. That'll be two.
7 points for Irby.
And the Blue has broken it open a little bit again here with Rodriguez back on the court and Irby back on the court.
Scoreboard says 25-13, so I guess that Irby shot was a two-pointer that I had as a three before.
Well, the Blue has definitely had the better of the play here this afternoon when they have the starters on the court.
It's nice of Rodriguez to give that other shot to Irby. She could have padded her scoring totals.
No look, but no hoop. They're in a hurry now, the Red.
Langley with the rebound. They can hold for the final shot. Kanoy going to try to take it away from Langley. And there's a kickball from Leathers. 4:09 to go. Much for Rodriguez near the half court logo.
It's one thing Langley could always do, handle the ball. All right. This will be a last shot, a very good one.
The clock never even started. But.
Not much defense there, David.
No. No, there was not. It's 27-13 at the half.
Adding to the red team's woes.
Still have 25 on the scoreboard.
Yeah, still 25, yeah.
Sabrina Rodriguez has 15 all by herself. She's beating the red team right now, 15-13.
She's doing a fine job. They're not going to take an extended halftime, of course, because they got a few games to play here.
We'll be back for the second half. 25 or 27-13. Second half of the alumni game about to begin. Blue team leading 25-13. Sabrina Rodriguez leading the way with 15 points.
Nice first half for her, huh?
Definitely.
I think she
beating
had
the red
this
team
game
by herself.
Marked on her calendar. I would always tell guys, the young players, particularly David, when I was in Division I, I would tell a kid, mark that game on your calendar, Let's watch this here. I'll be a name dropper just for one play, okay, and then I'll stop.
Make the name count.
Yeah, it's a decent name. You'll remember.
Here's Rodriguez going inside, couldn't score.
More.
Hey, she got it back, and she gets more.
Anyway, there was a young man named James Scott, and he had just had a very tough game against, I think, Georgetown, somebody. I don't even remember. And I was talking to him after the game, and I said, James, just circle that one on your calendar when you have the rematch with them. That's all. Don't worry about it.
And I'm sure he did.
Yeah, well, you had to think like that, Dave. It was such a good league,
Rodriguez had the shot blocked from behind. He'll stay with the blue team. And then these two teams will combine forces and take on the current Lady Tigers.
27-13. This lead has grown a little bit. Again, right off the bat. So they've been the better team throughout this game, and not taking anything away from anybody because they've all come out here and given it their all.
Torres puts up an air ball. She never got deterred when she missed. You would see some shooters think about it the next time. She didn't.
You can't. If you're going to be a shooter, you just can't do it.
And she would shoot from anywhere either. I think as soon as she got off the Q27, she was taking three-pointers.
You got to have a shooter's memory. There's your typical move by Barrow, and she got in there and got fouled. That brings me back. I watched her do that a few times on this court. We talked about all the great players they had. And, she's been one of the favorites, the way she played. Mm-hmm. You're a good teammate, good team player. That counts, too. You don't have to lead the league. You don't have to be the top player.
High arcing shot is no good. But last touch by Tiberi.
Now it'll go back to the blue, and they have to try to make something count here. They're down by 11, and they'd like to start their comeback a little bit.
Torres, it's a long two. Misses that one.
She hasn't had it on today.
But she's going to keep shooting.
And she should. If she finds her stroke, she can nail two or three of them and get them right back in the game. But she's got to be, of course, selective with what she does.
It was one game. She had the weirdest stat line I've seen. It's a nice move by Tiberi. Makes it a single-digit game, 27-18. I think Torres shot 0 for 12, and she was 0 for 11 from 3. It's an odd line. Were you here for the game where she broke her nose against Kingsborough? Did you see that one with Sean?
I think I was, yeah. Very quiet outside shooter,
Mm-hmm. They had a few girls who could hoist them. Torres, Harris, Jane Walsh. You had to defend Rodriguez, and Tiberi could hit a few threes, although not there.
Well, the team that lost 50-10 that you spoke about had a girl named Kristen Dross who used to shoot it from outside, and she would get her points that way because Moore would get her points going up and down the court.
Rodriguez hits the three-pointer.
They've had some really good outside shooters here.
That's 20 points for Rodriguez.
Pretty good day so far.
She's beating the red team 20-18, and the blue team is winning 30-18.
I wonder Weathers. If she tells him that, they'll let her on the bus free to go home. There you go.
And there's a nice foul move. Inside.
Yeah, let you on the bus free. Maybe they'll exempt her from the fare hike. I shouldn't say that. I have a lot of nice bus drivers that I deal with. They're so nice to me.
That three-pointer is
there
good.
There you go.
Tabiri answers back. It's 30-21. She could heat up.
Yep.
She could easily score 15 points and a half.
Well, they're within nine, Dave, and this is where you have to, you know, dig in, get the lunch pails out, and go to work.
Torres still trying to get in the scoring column.
Passes up the shot. Now she gets it.
And she hits. There's Torres for three. It's 33-21. It was only a matter of time.
Well, the guests have been on top the whole game, and if they get hot from out there, then it's really going to be tough. Then it's really going to be tough.
We'll stay with the red team. 15:54 to go. Blue team up 33-21. They've led since the start of the game. They jumped out to a 9-0 lead.
Let's see if they can get Kanoy involved from the red standpoint. She only has a field goal from what I have down.
I think she has 5 points.
5 points. They need her to do something because Rodriguez had such a great first half and she continues to score. There you go.
They tried getting it inside to Kanoy.
See what they run here.
There's Molina. There's a long three.
Well, you got to fight a three with a three.
Molina gets in the scoring column. It's 33-24.
Big shot. You got him right back within nine. Now they have to play some defense. Nope. Yep.
There's been more offense this half so far. Here's Harris. Harris up and under, throws up a wild one. And that's over the backboard.
She got caught under there and tried to make something happen. Now they're within nine, so you know, get another three, you're right back in the game.
Remember, the men's alumni game was decided at the buzzer. Here's Kanoy for three. And that one is rebounded by Rodriguez. Natasha Harris. The pass was too far in front of her.
Yep.
Molina. Now Irby's guarding her after Molina hit that really deep three. Kanoy going to the basket. And no good. There's an offensive rebound and a foul called on the way up.
Good offensive rebound there. They need more of that. They need more of that kind of team effort. And make the free throws, by the way. But that's easier said than done. Even from my standpoint, when you go to the line, it's always tough. play much basketball, Dave, yourself?
I did not. That's why I'm here announcing with you.
All right.
Free throws are split. It's 33-25.
That's what I like about you. You're Frank. Oh, no, you're Dave. That's right.
Here's Langley to Harris. Torres takes another three, and there's an air ball.
That was far wide. She's going to keep shooting it, though, David.
She will.
Don't let that bother her.
No.
Perfectly placed pass, but there was no way to go with it.
Canoy swoops in for the offensive rebound, and Rodriguez guarding Canoy.
Yep.
And Rodriguez with the steal.
They didn't see her there.
Rodriguez trying to go all the way and couldn't finish.
Ah. Sneaks into those passing lanes, of course. Yep.
And Langley
knocks it away from behind and causes a turnover, but they got it back.
So after all of that, it's red ball. They trail by eight.
Lots of rough sledding here.
Canoy.
I put it best, when Canoy's playing her best, she is annoying. She is Canoy and annoying. But that's when she plays her best, right there. She gets in the lane, she's pesky.
She annoyed the Bronx when Queensboro won by 50 in the CUNY championship game.
Yeah. Oh, got a piece of that.
It was a three-pointer that didn't hit the rim.
Well, they still have a chance at winding that down to six now, Dave.
13 minutes to play. Red team has never led, but they've stayed around.
Oh!
Nice spin move, and couldn't finish.
Everything but the basket.
The men's alumni game was 95-93 a few weeks ago. I don't think this is going to hit that score. Molina with the rebound. And then Irby called for the reach-in foul.
By the way, I was coming out here, and I grabbed in my notes a 2000 box score. Ben Choppingham is on the men's team in this box score, and I didn't bring it with me. I want to show it to you. I thought you would have gotten a kick out of it.
I would have. Coaching LaGuardia now.
Yep.
Did I tell you what his nickname was when he played here? Tom Sinnickson called him Benny Buckets.
He could play, huh?
And Pete Marchitello called him Benny Agbayani because they had the name, and he kind of looked like him.
Now he's a head coach, too.
Yeah. Ben was a Yankee fan, so I don't know if he'd appreciate
Benny
the Benny Agbayani comparison.
There's an old name.
A former Met. And Leathers hits a three. It's a five-point game.
Now a five-point game. They could have used Benny Agbayani this year, by the way. Now they just picked up a slugger.
Yeah. Langley for three.
Ooh, she got a hit,
almost.
Too. No call. They're not calling anything.
Under 12 minutes to play. Leathers.
Mets opening up the cash book a little.
Rolled it to Tiberi. Leathers puts up another three. That's no good. Williams with the offensive rebound.
Good rebound. Good hustle. Three could go.
Tiberi from downtown. It's 33-31.
All right. Now they're right back in this game. By the way, we can talk about the Mets a little bit, right? Because they're close by over here. We're not that far away from
them. No. 18-6 run for the red team, and Rodriguez is fouled.
I understand. No talk show on the Mets, though. We won't do that. I've heard enough of that, by the way.
Rodriguez inbounding.
So who do you think the Mets will put in the eighth position this year? I don't know. 33-31. It'll be thrown in from underneath.
Joe
taking his little run at talk radio.
Yeah.
Whoop.
Well, Torres couldn't hit from inside either. It's the closest shot I've seen her taken.
Dave, I promise I'll stop.
Red team can take the lead now with this Leathers three. And she hits. 34-33.
How about that? How about that? There's an old fella used to say that.
Torres, there's a three. And she hit.
Yeah.
Now we have a good ball game going on.
That shot inside was just for show. She was really setting them up for the next three-pointer she was taking. Leathers trying to answer
everybody
back again.
Everybody wants to get in the action. Good rebound by Barrow. You know, the girls are exciting because they really shoot the three, the ladies. They're not shy about it.
Whether they make them or not.
And that's always been a trademark of the women. They love those threes. Oh, trying to buy the foul, but not a good enough sell job there.
I think a little too dramatic as Gonzalez puts it in off glass.
They came right back, Dave, and they grabbed the lead again. Right back. They had the lead for a fleeting couple of seconds there.
It's a nice thought to try to get the flop. I mean, she looked like she got hit by sniper fire as opposed to just
too
an
dramatic,
elbow. So, yeah,
too
a
dramatic.
Little bit much.
They got to give her some flop lessons there.
Should be in every coach's playbook.
Of course, you got to commend her on the effort, though.
Rodriguez puts it in. It's 40-34 and a 7-0 run for the blue team.
So Q-Rod going to the basket.
About 22 points for Sabrina.
She's done a good job here this afternoon.
Red team did all that work to come back from a 14-point deficit, finally took the lead, and then the blue team scored 7 points in a row.
Nice pass. Nice give inside, but Tabiri saying, I should have made it. Now she gets another opportunity.
She just wanted to pad her rebounding stats. It's 40-36. Tabiri has 10 points now.
As they tell you, you know, Dave, if you don't succeed, just stay in there and try again. And she did it three times because she got the basket there. Oh, nice no-look pass, but nowhere to go with it.
And Torres.
There you go.
That's her third three. It's 43-36.
See, she's on a roll now. Before, she was ice cold. But, you know, that's the shooter's mentality.
Yeah.
There was a guy who used to play for the Knicks, Hubert Davis. Remember Hubert Davis? That's an old name now, by the way.
Oh! Rodriguez is found. Torres is really one of the streakiest shooters.
You know, so many years have gone by with this game of basketball that now when you mention Hubert Davis, people are, who's he? Well, Hubert Davis played for North Carolina.
More people probably remember him now as the ESPN analyst.
And, well, see, they will know his name then to a certain extent. But Hubert was like an outside shooting factory. And every time he would play at the Garden, they'd play bang, I don't want to work. I just want to bang my drum all day, because that's what he did. He'd just literally shoot about five in a row and just knock the other team clear out of the game or something, or try to. You know? And that's what we saw here. It's just shoot, shoot, shoot. Downtown Fred Brown, people like that. You know, they didn't know the inside shot. Forget about these.
Rodriguez makes both. It's 45-36.
You know, Dave, remember guys that say he never met an outside shot a shot he didn't like? Remember that?
Yeah, there are a lot of players here that.
Well, that's an easy way of saying someone's a chuck anyway. without making it too apparent. But no, Davis was not a chucker. He's just an outside shooter.
Kanoy with the offensive rebound. Takes a shot herself.
Ah.
Then they get it back. And misses again. Wonder what the red team is shooting now. 20%?
Not very well, but they've hit those threes at the proper time and then got back in the game. And now another tremendous move by Rodriguez is just showing she hasn't left much since she left the program here.
How low would the score be if not for Rodriguez?
It would be 36-20, I think, right now.
This is the first.
Not good at the free throw line that time. Let's see if she gets this one.
That was her one issue when she was Region Player of the Year in 2012. She only shot about 44% from the line.
See, Dave, you come up with... See, I like when you do that. That's why you're on the top of the game right now.
Rodriguez splits the free throws. 25 points.
Dave's good. I mean, I tried to come up with some history, and Dave will just dive right into it. So I know that. And I remember that.
46-36, blue team, 7.5 to play.
He doesn't do it like a wise guy either. He knows it. He just knows, and he studies all that stuff. Here's a miss.
Harris with the rebound.
Well, they shot themselves into the game with the three, but they can't shoot themselves back into it now. But they're down by 10.
Torres. Blue team on a 13-2 run.
That's quite a run. You go that way, I'll throw this way. Then we'll go back this way.
And Harris is fouled underneath and hits the floor. Under 7 minutes to play.
Funniest thing I ever dealt with, Dave, is there was a guy, my friend, that used to do the color with me when we did Army basketball.
Mm-hmm.
We were playing this fella named Lionel Simmons. And he would go in the lane. He was a marvelous player. Played in the NBA, Philadelphia. Played with LaSalle University. First free throw, no good. Anyway, Lionel would take no prisoners. He was just great. And he would get in a lane, and three Army players hit him. And then my friend said, because he had a shaven head. The way they call that foul is they pick out the sound that was the loudest on top of his head, and that guy gets the foul. And I just started cracking up. I said, that's a very good way of looking at it, Bill. You couldn't stop this guy. He was just all, he was like Air Jordan almost in the Mac. And meanwhile, the red team continues to try to get back in the game, and they get within 8 here.
Leathers in double-digit scoring now with the 11. Torres puts up another 3. And it's good. 49-38. That's 4 threes for Torres.
Wow. She's had it on in the last 6, 7, 8 minutes.
Couldn't answer back.
That might have been the biggest shot of the game right there that she just hit, too.
For all of her struggles, she has a dozen points now.
Whoop.
Langley's pass went one way and Harris was going another. Red team will have it, 6:08 to play. They trail by 11.
They had the lead there for about 2 seconds, and then it got right back in the blue column.
Tough shot is no good. Loose ball going out of bounds. One ref looks at the other. And it will stay with the red team. Canoy, it's a long 2, and it's no good. And Torres there with the rebound.
Up. Well, they'll need some turnovers now to get back in the game, and they get one here. It was almost.
You might say deflected. Or will they?
They won't.
So everybody was walking back the other way. Nobody cared that the ref said.
Now they're going to go back this way.
Ref is pointing. He was pointing blue ball and everybody ignored him. Of course, he's the only guy that matters, so blue ball. And now it's red ball. So 3 seconds later, but the red team finally gets it.
By the way, my comment about the shaved head playing basketball, you know, people think that that was always a trend, but there were trendsetters in that regard. Slick Watts, the guy I mentioned, Simmons, you know, not everybody had that at that time. Hard to believe, right? Like the internet. There was no internet either. Or very little of it.
If tough life.
Somebody's basement, maybe.
Langley, her foot was on the line. It's a 2, and it's good. Elise Langley makes it 51-38. She's in the scoring column now, and the scoreboard says 52, even though it was really a 2-pointer. They give her 3.
She travel. She traveled on that. This game looks like it's being put to bed right now, but we'll see. Good effort by all these girls. Let's give them all a round of applause. They've all given us a good show, just like the men did here a few weeks ago.
It's not over. They still have another game to play as Harris misses a three. By the way, it's a 19-4 run right now by the blue team.
By the way, Tom Sinnickson told me he's going to get into one of these games one of these years. So
that's gonna
I'm
be
looking
fun.
Forward to that.
And Kanoy throws it off Langley. Langley
that
laughing
be
about
fun,
it.
Right?
Yeah. Under 5 minutes to play, 13-point game. Kanoy in the corner puts up a three, and it's no good.
Elsie trying to measure her way to the basket. She saw that bigger girl alongside. And
timeout taken by the blue team.
They need it because this is going to be their... Well, no, they don't need it. Actually, the red team.
Maybe for
it.
Rest.
Yeah, they're down by plenty now, and this will be the final chance Herman has to instill some fire into them.
We're going to have to get on Herman's case. Losing one of these alumni games?
No, we could never get on Herman's case. He's too nice a guy. We have to be very delicate about it, Dave.
We'll still bust his chops,
yes,
though.
Yes, we will. We're going to get a look at the current Queensborough squad here shortly, and they have a big game here during the week, don't they?
Yeah, they get LaGuardia here on Thursday. There might be more players in the alumni game from last year than are on the current Queensborough team. Only Candija Carroll and Whitney Hogan are returning.
Yeah, and LaGuardia is their main contender.
Yeah. How fun was the doubleheader here last year in November? That was entertaining.
Beautiful doubleheader. That was the first one we did. And LaGuardia, by the way, not flying in here. They'll be taking the bus in here.
And the women's team for Queensborough won by 25. It's not that men's game that we saw. That was one of the best games we've seen in this conference.
They have a real good athletic director, too. That guy's a nice guy.
Brian
Very
Goldstein. Kanoy. Puts it in. The red team hits the 40-point mark.
That looked more like Kanoy right there. She hasn't done that very much today.
7 points.
She might try to pick it up here in these final 4 minutes. Let's see. You know, she's been famous for doing that, by the way. She seems to be more involved right now, directing people and...
I'm glad we're not keeping track of turnovers and missed shots.
If they came back, this would be one of her greatest comebacks ever in this game.
I think she would still put the CUNY Championship ahead of this game.
I think so. But just in terms of the ability to come back from a big score with not much time left. They went after that ball hard, and they get called for the foul there.
Harris was pushed out by Barrow.
Two girls with a lot of muscle there. They both very strong.
Langley to Rodriguez in a crowd of red jerseys dribbles out.
Who would you give the star of the game to, Dave, if they hold on?
Gonna have to think. I'm gonna go with Rodriguez.
Yeah. She has enough points. And she just made a play there and continued in. As you said, she was very talented here, and they couldn't get over top in her years here. They finished first, and they couldn't do it in the tournament.
Kanoy all the way and puts it in. It's a single-digit game again, 51-42.
It's not over yet.
3:10 to play. Harris to Torres, back to Harris. Irby asking for it, and the pass is stolen. It was intercepted by Barrow.
Oh, big comeback attempt here.
Kanoy, the pull-up jumper is good. It's 51-44.
Oh, boy, Kanoy.
Annoying the blue team.
Annoying. That's when she's at her best.
Langley is fouled by Kanoy.
These are not going to be gimme free throws if there are any.
I think it's going to be a 1-1 now. So Langley at the line.
Getting a little encouragement from the blue bench to hit these.
Langley misses the first. And traveling is called.
They got tied up with each other.
Williams and Kanoy were fighting for it. And they forgot that they were on the same team and didn't need to fight for it and traveled. And now the blue team has it back.
Gotta look at that uniform. Oh, good play.
Barrow got the hand in as Harris was going up.
2:35, David. They still have an opportunity, but they're going to make some plays here.
Here's Torres. Torres takes a three, and it's no good. That could have been the exclamation point.
They got to get a very good shot here. They can't rush this.
Leathers. Leathers going inside, and it's a five-point game. 51-46, 8 points in a row.
Wow. Well, Kanoy got it started, as she usually does. And there is now 2:15 on the clock, so this is very doable here. Let's see who they go to on the blue squad here. I want to get the ball to Rodriguez at some point.
I was going to say, you don't have to think about too hard, Joe. It's Harris and Irby. Back to Harris. Langley takes a long two and misses. So Rodriguez didn't actually touch it on that possession, and the red team will have the ball with under 2 minutes to play.
Blue team having trouble putting this one away.
Tiberi left alone for three. It's no good. Rodriguez with the rebound. And in the corner, gets it to Langley. And Langley is fouled by Kanoy. Langley will go back to the free throw line for a 1-1.
He just missed one about 5 minutes ago. Not on the clock, but in
real time.
Actual time. Thinking about it with her hands up on her head, and now she'll settle in to try to get these, and these could be very big ones here if she can make the front end.
Langley misses the first. Red team still hanging around. Here's Barrow to Leathers. Barrow asking for it back. Got it.
Get a good shot.
Williams outside to Beery. Back to Barrow for three, and it's no good. Rodriguez with the rebound. Double teamed and a tie up.
Rodriguez got caught with the dribble over there on the sideline. Always say that sideline's an extra defender in that situation, and that's what it is. She was fortunate that they had the tie up. Now you want to move it away from that sideline and get rid of the ball real quick.
Rodriguez. It's called for traveling.
Too quick.
Red team will get the ball back with 1:07 to play.
Well, it's been a good ball game, Dave. They took us down to the 1:07 mark here, and it's still within striking distance, so we'll see if they can somehow pull it out.
Red team has scored the last 8 points.
It's got to be Kanoy here.
And Kanoy misses a three. Barrow almost got the rebound but couldn't. Loose ball, Gonzalez got it. Langley hit the line. And
out
Langley
of
can't believe it,
he's
but they say
bounds,
red ball.
Yeah. Yep. I was going to say that Kanoy miss might have been their last chance, but they get new life here.
5 point game. Tiberi steps into a three, and it's good. Tiberi has 13 points. It's 51-49.
Always a big game performer, Nikki Tiberi. Now
Langley's
in trouble again. He's trying to get out of it.
And she stepped on the line.
Again. That's twice.
Like you said, the sideline is an extra defender. Red team can tie or take the lead. They can send this to overtime.
Now this is more serious than it's ever been.
Sabiri.
Still a lot of time.
Weathers for the lead. Got it.
Oh.
52-51 red team. 14 points in a row, excuse me.
Now we have to ask Herman Crump what he said to them during that timeout at about 5 minutes. Because it must have been a very inspiring message there.
Down 51-38, Herman Crump said something to his team, and now they've scored 14 points in a row. And they lead 52-51. The red team is led for about 10 seconds in this game, and they might win it.
Herman must have said something to them like, go out and win. And they did, almost. Let's see. They
got 30.
They got 50 seconds.
30 seconds.
So if they can hold on here, it'll be one of the big comebacks in Queensboro alumni history. See,
for those keeping track,
you got to throw the alumni in there.
Yeah.
Have you seen a bigger comeback than this one in alumni games so far?
All right. This is definitely the best alumni game I've seen.
Yeah, we're right in there with that one. The men's game was very good, too.
Yeah. For the women's side, this has been the best alumni game.
Good turnout of kids, good players on the court today. All the best players from the Queensboro dynasties. So good sampling of talented young ladies. I'd say it's been a smashing success. Right now, the blue team's hoping that they can pull it out. They've led basically the whole game.
Harris flips it to Irby and throws it away. Tiberi, they need to foul. 15 seconds to go. And Irby gives a foul with 14 and 2:10 seconds remaining. They still have a few to give. So not free throws just yet.
Yeah, no free throws. They'll have to steal the ball here, basically, or they have to foul, get him to the line right away.
They may decide not to foul. I don't know. They're waiting.
Got a foul.
10 seconds left.
And now they're going to have to foul again, by the way. That's not enough, so they won't. They won't get the ball back till they commit another foul, and another 4 seconds went off the clock there.
Kanoy.
Foul.
Gets it into Tiberi.
Fowler.
And Tiberi is fouled with 7.5 seconds to go.
Heartbreaking loss if they do lose this one, as far as alumni games go. We got to get one more, by the way. One more foul. They're not at the limit yet.
5 seconds, 4 seconds. Looked like she lost it before she actually got fouled with 2:08:10 to go. It's weird, after they gave the first foul, and I didn't see it actually go up on the scoreboard, so they may have needed to foul one extra time. 2:08:10 to go.
Game's basically over, and they're going to need some kind of miracle shot now to pull this out. So we'll
we may
see.
Need to revoke Sabrina's MVP.
Yeah, sure, they'll do that.
If it was a real thing in this game, which it's not.
Well, maybe they'll do it in an alumni way, you know.
53-51. I said Tiberi could score 15 points. She has 14 right
now.
Yeah,
who's the star of the game now, Dave?
That's, I guess, Simone one. Leathers.
Yeah.
This is in Williams.
See, the game's over. That's it.
So the blue team led for about 39 minutes in this one, and the red team wins 53-51.
They don't know what hit them.
They scored the last 15 points of the game.
Well, it's all in fun, and it's all for the betterment of Queensboro basketball, and thanks to all these young ladies for showing up today, because they give it a lot of effort, of course, coming out here and reminding us of what great players they were when they played here.
It was an entertaining game. Simone Leathers hitting the go-ahead three-pointer in the final minute. She led the way for the red team with 16 points. Tiberi had 14. Kanoy had 11.
You know what the great thing about this, Dave, is Queensborough can't lose in this. They just don't lose in this game at all.
Still undefeated in the alumni game.
Still undefeated. And even the current team, they'll be hard-pressed now to beat this collective group of stars here. Let's see what they're able to do in the nightcap.
They have to take on the team with Shantana Canoy and Sabrina Rodriguez.
I'll tell you why. I think this is going to be a little more entertaining than the men's second game was because you actually have the stars of Queensborough basketball out here today.
Yeah.
In past years. Cool. And you've covered them for a few years. So.
Yeah. So we'll be back for game two of the doubleheader. For Joe Massey, this is David Russell. Queensborough, the red team beat the blue team 53-51.